Hello guys, welcome to the 17th episode of Figure Type of Support series. In each episode, I'll show you guys figure types or supports made by me, mostly, or by someone else. The archetype for this episode is for the Battle Wasp, or you can call them B4s. The first card here is Battle Wasp Arbalest the Rapid Fire. It's a Wind Level 4 Insect Effect Monster with 1800 attack, 800 defense. Its effect reads, if this card is destroyed, you can special summon one Battle Wasp monster from your hand. If this card destroys an opponent monster by battle and sent to the graveyard, you can special summon one level 4 or lower Battle Wasp monster from your deck. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a synchro summon of an insect type synchro monster, you can inflict 200 damage to your opponent. As you can see from this first card, it's really different from its actual enemy effect. So this is my take on what would their real effects be. So as you can see, the first effect is pretty much its actual enemy effect. And the rest of it is pretty much what my take on is going to be next effects. So it's pretty much Hydra get on, blah blah blah. But when he gets used for a single summon, he has an effect, which is just only to inflict 200 damage. Because they are a mass summoning archetype, as well as inflict 200, 300, 400, 500 damage to your opponent. So yeah. The next card here is Battle Wasp Dart the Hunter. It's a win level 1. Insect effect monster with 100 attack, 100 defense. Its effect reads, if you control the face of Battle Wasp monster, you can special summon this card from your hand. If a face of Battle Wasp monster you control destroys an opponent monster by battle, you can send this card from your hand to the graveyard, inflict damage to your opponent equal to the attack of the destroyed monster. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a single summon of an insect type synchro monster, you could destroy one monster in the field. As you can see, the main focus what I take on this is that when they're used as a synchro material, they gain an effect. Like the previous one, only inflicts 200 damage to your opponent, while this card destroys one monster in the field. So it could be yours or your opponent's. It could be face up, face down, so yeah. The next card is Battle Wasp, Pin the Bullseye. It's a win level 1 insect effect monster with 200 attack, 300 defense. Its effect reads, if you control no monster, you can special summon this card from your hand. If this card is summoned, you can add one Battle Wasp monster from your deck to your hand. And if you do, inflict 200 damage to your opponent. Once per turn, you can normal summon one Battle Wasp monster in addition to your normal summon of set this turn. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a synchro summon of an insect type synchro monster, you can destroy one spell trap card on the field. As you can see, this card's pretty much a one card synchro summon for Battle Wasp. So, because if you control a normal monster, you could spell summon this card, and when you spell summon, you get to add one Battle Wasp monster, most likely someone you can actually normal summon, or probably someone else. So, yeah. The next card here is Battle Wasp. Twin Bow the Attacker. It's a Wind Level 3 Insect Effect Monster with 1000 attack, 500 defense. Its effect reads, if you control a face-up Battle Wasp monster, you can special summon this card from your hand. All face-up insect type monsters you control can make a second attack during each battle phase. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a synchro summon of an insect type synchro monster, you can add one Battle Wasp monster from your deck to your hand. So pretty much its actual enemy effect was just allowing everyone attack twice and also special summon itself when you control a Battle Wasp. So I think the only thing I added for this one was actually the synchro effect, where if he was used a synchro's material, you can add one Battle Wasp monster from your deck to your hand. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this card. The next card here is Battle Wasp Sting the Poison. It's a Wind Level 2 Insect Tuner Effect Monster with 400 attack, 800 defense. Its effect reads, if this card is summoned, you can target one level 4 or lower Battle Wasp monster in your graveyard. Special summon that target. And if you do, inflict 200 damage to your opponent. Once per turn, you can tribute one insect type monster you control to special summon one level 4 lower Battle Wasp monster from your deck. And if you do, target one face up monster your opponent controls, its effects are negated. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a single summon of an insect type single monster, you can add one Battle Wasp monster from your graveyard to your hand. Pretty much this is one of the tuner monsters for them, and the other next two ones are gonna be the other two the tuner monsters that I created. That was not really part of the anime, so yeah. The next card here is Battle Wasp Bolt the Wallenbird. It's a Wind Level 4 Insect Tuner Effect Monster with 1300 attack, 400 defense. Its effect reads, you can special summon this card from your hand by returning one face-up card you control to the hand. Each time your opponent special summons a monster, inflict 200 damage to them immediately after the summons resolved. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a single summon of an insect-type synchro monster, you can add one spell and trap card that listed the word Battle Wasp on it from your deck to your hand. So this is pretty much the second tuner monster for them, since Sting the Poison was the only one in the original archetype, so why not make another one? The next card here is Battle Wasp Slurbo the Slayer is a wind level 3 insect tuner effect monster with 1400 attack, 1000 defense. Its effect creates during either player's damage step. If a battle wasp monster you control attacks or attack, you can send this card from your hand to the graveyard. That monster gains attack equal to the combined attack of all face-up insect type monsters you control until the end of its turn. If this card battles an opponent's monster whose attack is greater than this card, double this card's attack until the end of the damage calculation. If this card is destroyed by battle or by card effect, you can special summon one banished battle wasp monster. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a synchro summon of an insect type synchro monster, you can return one card on the field to its owner's hand. As you can see, this card is really good because it has the return one card on the field effect when you use it as a synchro material. Since this is a tuner monster, you're mostly going to be using it as a synchro material, so yeah. Unless you just go spam level 3s, yeah. The next card here is Battle Wasp Halberd the Charge. It's a wind level 6 insect synchro effect monster with 2500 attack, 800 defense. It requires 1 tuner plus 1 or more non-tuner monsters. Its effect reads, if this card battles an opponent's monster with a higher attack than this card, half that monster's original attack during the damage calculation only. Once per turn, during either player's turn, you can target one set card your opponent controls, destroy it. And if you do, inflict 200 damage to your opponent. So this card is pretty much a generic insect synchro for Battle Wasp, because that is what it requires in the anime, so yeah. And its effect to destroy one set card is pretty good too, because it inflict damage and there's some inflict damage. The next card is Battle Wasp Hammer the Conquering Bow. It's a wind level 8 insect synchro effect monster with 2100 attack, 2000 defense. It requires 1 tuner synchro monster plus 1 or more non-tuner Battle Wasp monster. Its effect reads, if this card can attack twice during your battle phase. Once per turn, if this card inflicts battle damage to your opponent, you can target one face-up monster your opponent controls, it loses attack equal to that amount of damage. At the end of the battle phase, if no damage was inflicted this turn, you can inflict 300 damage to your opponent for each battle wasp monster in your graveyard. So this card is pretty much another burn card for battle wasp, because if you don't inflict damage during the end of the battle phase, you can just burn your opponent for game, because you can do that. And discard cards are twice, so meaning if you destroy one monster, you can reduce the attack of another monster and attack that one. So pretty simple, even though the requirement is one tuner single monster, so yeah. The next card here is Battle Wasp Azusa the Ghost Bow. It's a wind level 5 insect synchro tuner effect monster with 2200 attack, 1600 defense. It requires 1 tuner plus 1 or more non-tuner monsters. Its effect reads, during your player's turn, if a battle wasp monster would inflict damage while you control another battle wasp monster, you can double that damage once per battle phase. If a face of battle wasp monster is targeted for an attack, you can negate the attack, and if you do, inflict 200 damage to your opponent. Yet again, another burn card. And it's a synchro tuner, so you can actually use this card to summon Hama the Conquering Bow. And it's a generic one, so if you want to run a burn synchro deck, this is your monster, but you need Battle Wasp for it, so yeah. The next card here is Battle Wasp Shigeru the Unison Bow. It's a wind level 7 insect synchro tuner effect monster with 2600 attack, 1800 defense. It requires 1 tuner plus 1 or more non-tuner Battle Wasp monster. Its effect reads, if this card is synchro summoned, you can target one level 8 or lower insect type monster in your graveyard. Special summon it. And if you do, inflict damage to your opponent equal to its level times 200. While you control another face-up battle wasp monster, all face-up insect-type monsters you control cannot be destroyed by battle by card effect. As you can see, this card is really good because it protects your insect-type monsters and it burns your opponent when it's a synchro summon. But you mostly gotta be summoning this to protect your monsters. That's it. The next card here is Battle Wasp Drill the Blaster. It's a wind level 2 insect synchro of tuner effect monster with 800 attack, 2000 defense. It requires 1 tuner plus 1 or more non-tuner Battle Wasp monster. The effect reads, if a face-up Battle Wasp monster attacks or attack, you can discard one Battle Wasp monster from your hand or banish it from graveyard. That monster gains 2000 attack and defense until the end of the battle phase. Once per turn, you can target one banished Battle Wasp monster added to your hand. If this card was sent to the graveyard for a single summon of an insect-type synchro monster, you can draw one card. So this card is pretty much collude for Battle Wasp, because you discard one Battle Wasp, that monster gains 2000 attack instead of 1400, so. But the difference is that it's a synchro monster, not an effect monster. And when this card is used as synchro material, you draw one card, which is pretty much the counterpart for Formula Synchron. Because when Formula Synchron is summoned, you draw one card. While this card is used as synchro material, you draw one card. The next card here is Battle Wasp Ballista the Armageddon. It's a wind level 12 insect synchro effect monster with 3000 attack, 3000 defense. They're a boss monster. It requires 1 tuner plus 2 or more non-tuner Battle Wasp monsters. Its effect reads, cannot be attributed, unaffected by your opponent's card effects. Once per turn, during any player's turn, you can banish as many Battle Wasp monsters from your graveyard. All monsters your opponent currently controls loses 500 attack for each monster banished this way. Then, if their attack has been reduced to 0 as a result, destroy them. Once per turn, you can return as many banished Battle Wasp monsters to your graveyard. All face-up Battle Wasp monsters you currently control gains 500 attack for each monster returned this way. If this card attacks a defense position monster, inflict piercing battle damage to your opponent. As you can see, this card's effects are pretty decent and powerful, because it's unaffected by opponent's card effects, it cannot be attributed, and when it reduces your opponent's monster's attacks to 0, it'll automatically destroy them like Slifer. Not only that, it increases your monster's attack for every banished you return to the graveyard, and has piercing damage, and combine this card with Shigeru the Unison Bow, it cannot be destroyed by battle or by card effect. That's pretty much the boss monster for Battle Wasp. The next card here is the Summoning Swarm. It's a normal spell card that reads, if your opponent controls a monster or monsters, spell summon level 4 or lower Battle Wasp monster from your graveyard, equal to the number of monsters your opponent controls. If a face-up insect type monster will be destroyed by battle by card effect, while this card is in your graveyard, you can banish this card instead. As you can see, this card is pretty much sole choice for the Battle Wasp, because if your opponent controls 5 monsters, and you control none, you can spell summon up to 5. And if your instant type monster will be destroyed by battle by card effect, you can banish this card instead, so it has a protection effect. The next card here is Revival Swarm. It's a normal spell card that reads, target one Battle Wasp monster in your graveyard. Spell summon it, but its effects are negated. Also, it cannot be destroyed by battle by card effect this turn. If a face-up instant type monster will be destroyed by battle by card effect while this card is in your graveyard, you can banish this card instead. As you can see, this card is Monster Reborn, Call of the Haunted for the Battle Wasp, and that's the second effect of the previous card, where if an instant type monster will be destroyed by battle by card effect, you can protect it. So yeah. The next card here is Battle Wasp Nest. It's a continuous trap card that reads, activate this card by targeting one level 4 or lower Battle Wasp monster you control. If that target or a monster with the same name as that target is targeted for an attack, you can spell summon one level 4 or lower Battle Wasp monster from your hand or deck. And if you do, end the battle phase. If this effect was used twice, destroy this card. If that target needs a field, destroy this card. During your main phase, instead of the turn this card was sent to the graveyard, you can banish this card from your graveyard, add up to 3 Battle Wasp monster from your graveyard to your hand. So this is another card that actually spams more Battle Wasp as long as your Battle Wasp monster is being targeted for an attack. Also, but if it's used twice, it gets destroyed. But there's also a plus side, because once it's in the graveyard, the next turn, you could activate his second effect to add up to 3 Battle Wasp monsters from your graveyard to your hand, so to get back your tuners and non-tuner monsters. And the last card here is Battle Wasp Formation. It's a continuous trap card that reads, activate this card by targeting one Battle Wasp monster you control. Each time your opponent summons a monster or monsters, that target gains 400 attack. If that target leaves the field, you can destroy this card instead. During your main phase, except the turn this card was sent to the graveyard, you can banish this card from your graveyard, spell summon one Battle Wasp monster from your graveyard, but its effects are negated. As you can see, this card is really decent, because if you're facing an opponent that spams a lot of monsters, that Battle Wasp monster that you just target gains more than just 400 attack. And if that Battle Wasp monster will leave the field, you can just destroy this card instead. And the next turn, you can just banish this card and spell summon another Battle Wasp monster from your graveyard. It could be your boss monster or other Battle Wasp monster. So it's pretty decent. It has some pros and cons because it's a trap card and you have to set it first. So yeah. And that's all for the cards for the Battle Wasp. I don't know if these effects will make them top tier or broken, but I wanna see what you guys think in the comments below. So thanks for watching, leave a like, comment, subscribe, and thanks. And let's see what happens next.